Hello, welcome to my introduction to C programming on the computer. First of all, I'd like to show you a bit about how a computer works behind the scenes. So, you know that in a computer you have memory, which is usually known as RAM. There's also ROM, which is really the BIOS, which is a set of basic instructions that can get the computer up and running and performs self-test on the hardware and stuff like that. In the RAM is what we're going to be working with C mainly, and you also have a CPU, which is a central processing unit, which is a device that can carry out instructions on data that's in RAM, and it can also control the movement of data and keep track of where the program is up to. This could be a hard disk drive, might have a monitor and a keyboard, and all this stuff is I/O, and all of these things are connected onto what's called the system bus. Now that means that something can be put onto the bus, and if something is ready to receive it, it will be sent down to that system. It's almost just like a network, where instead of having different computers, you have different pieces of hardware on the network or bus. So this is the bus. Now the CPU is what we use when we program to carry out our instructions, but it can only understand ones and zeros, which is binary. Now these instructions can ask the CPU to do certain things, like you might want to add two numbers together that are in memory, or you might want to add two numbers together that are in the CPU's own memory called registers. And usually we don't have to worry about where our data is stored, but just know that the CPU uses registers whenever it can, and they're a lot quicker than memory. But what's in memory? In memory there is programmed data, things that we want to work on, like numbers, and there's also program code, which is a series of these instructions. So they're in memory somewhere as well. So everything is in memory, and everything has an address. So everything is controlled by the CPU, but it all resides in memory somewhere. So for now, just think of it as where everything takes place, where all the information is in there. Now, what is memory? Memory is just a series of electronic storage locations. So the way we can see memory is it is a big list of addresses, and there might be billions of these, and they've all got their own address. Now, as I said, there are instructions for the CPU, so you might have instructions, more instructions at address 0, 1, 2, and then down here you might have some data, which is a number, and that's, say, address 1000, 1001, 1002, and there's data in those three locations, but realistically we're looking at many more. Now instructions are the same as data. If you looked at memory and you could see all the ones and zeros in all the different addresses, it would all look like a series of ones and zeros. There's nothing special about instructions or data. There's nothing to tell you that what is in memory is a certain thing. So the only difference is where these things get sent to. Now the instructions get sent to the CPU to be processed, and those instructions might tell the CPU to get something from a memory location. So this might be an instruction, and it might tell the CPU to go to memory location 1000 and put that whatever number is there, which it might just be one, something like that, put that number in a register. Now it has to be a register big enough to hold one byte, which is, you can use eight binary digits in one byte. So what you'll find is this might be a register one. The name's not important. So what's happened is this instruction, the CPU knows where it's up to in the programs, because it has a special register that keeps track of which instruction to carry out, and it'll start going through the instructions in the program in a list. So this is the instruction pointer, or IP. It'll say, right, I'm at zero, and that means the computer, the CPU, will get the instruction from here, which happened to be this number, and that told it to go and get data from 1000 and put it into register one. And that might look a bit weird, but that's basically how the program runs. And there are other instructions that can say, go back to, once you get to here, this instruction might say to make the CPU go back to memory location zero, so that the program will keep going around and around, and that's called a loop. But basically, we're working with data in memory, and there's also instructions in memory. And this is nothing like C, this is just a bit of a background as to why we would use C instead of doing things with numbers like this. As you can see, you'd have to look up a chart that tells you what these numbers do to the CPU. It'd be hard to remember them all, some people might be able to, but what we're going to be doing is putting data into memory, and then we can do stuff with it. We won't be using directly, we won't be using machine instructions like this, we'll just be using things that we can understand in English. Now, another thing to remember is that some data is it needs more than one memory location. So, for example, in C programming we have what's called integers. In mathematics they're integers. In C they are called int, and they take up 4 bytes generally. On most home computers you'll be looking at a piece of data that is 4 bytes long. So you'd start, if you had the first part of your integer was at memory location 1000, it would go to memory location 1003, and then that'd be your integer in those 4 locations. And all you need to worry about was the starting address. So that's about it for the raw background. I think it'd be best now to have a look at a C program working, and we'll get back to this, but this is just an introduction, and hopefully you can see that it's fairly simple. So just to summarize, we have memory, billions of locations that all have their own unique address, and what's stored in that memory is ones and zeros, binary numbers. Now they have an equivalent in decimal, but that's not important. We don't have to worry about what these numbers are. And the computer, or the CPU, will have certain devices within it that tell it to read instructions from memory, and these instructions are carried out by the CPU, and they can make it perform operations on data. It can add 2 bits of data together, and you can move data around in memory. Like, for instance, you could take this integer and store it down at location 1,000,000 or something like that. So that's basically what we're doing, is putting things into memory at certain addresses, and also getting the CPU to do certain things by sending it instructions.